And I'm back at my ghetto spot today. It's got a really deep one-way signal, Indian head penny signal. And it was coming up 38 like a zinc penny. It's pretty deep though. There's only one way. And let me clean this up, hold on. I can't believe it's a goddamn wheat penny. That was a solid 1238. I guess the iron was messing with my signal in there. I thought that was an Indian head for sure. Oh wow. Alright, today I'm at a little city park I've been to before. And I'm in a high iron spot right here, and I'm running two-tone ferrous. And I just popped this out. Okay, I'm not having a whole lot of luck here today. A few Wheaties. That's about it. Still using the two-tone ferrous. I just popped this out. It wasn't very deep. Sort of interesting. I don't know what this is. Looks like it could have been a button. Like a reeded edge. Looks like it's been hit by a mower. Wasn't very deep. What? This is a very old park I'm at here. It's from the late 1600s, so who knows? Okay, I've been here about 2 hours already. Got sick of the two-tone ferrous. I just dug this up, and it's an Indian head penny. I already filled the hole back in. I thought it was going to be a zinc penny. But that is an Indian head. It's only about 4 inches down there. Oh, let's get a date off of this. Looks like 1905. Cool. My only old coin today. Okay, I just spent quite a bit of time on this one. This was very deep 40 signal. Turned out to be a very tiny buckle. There you go. That was a pain in the ass. Okay, today I'm back at a little city park I've been to before. And as you can see, I no longer have my probe. I was getting a lot of falsing signals from the probe and the coil, so I sent it back for repair. I'm just under the warranty. I got about a week left on the warranty, so hopefully they fix it. Anyway, it's very frustrating with no pinpointer. I tried. So today I went out and bought the Cen-Tech. I got a Harbor Freight not far from me. So I went out and got one. $16.99. And I got my first success here. No, it's not even working. Hold on a sec. Alright, I must have touched the sensitivity knob. So this thing's really cheap. I mean, I know these things don't last very long, but right out of the box, it's working pretty good. sorta. Picking up the coin about half an inch. Oh wow. It works anyway. Sorta. Let's see what we got here. Ooh, this looks like it might be something good. I don't know if I should rub this. Looks like it might be a barber. Never found a seated here. Look. I don't know if I should rub this. Hold on a sec. Alright, it's a barber dime. 1905. Pretty good shape. Wasn't real deep. 5-6 inches maybe. There you go. Man, is this a pain in the ass? I'm carrying all this. I'm not used to carrying all this crap in my belt. Damn. Alright. Alright, this was last time I was here, I didn't have my probes. It was a few days ago. And I had no pinpointer. And this was a hole I dug already. I got a real iffy penny signal. And it drove me nuts. I couldn't find it. Spent 20 minutes. Ended up digging two separate holes next to each other. I still couldn't find it. So I had to fill it in and go back home. There it is. It was a piece of junk. I don't know what that is, but it's a piece of crap. Alright, I'm getting a zinc, sort of a zinc penny signal here. It's real iffy. My Cen-Tech is indicating right here. Let's see. It's a washer. Alright, it's a different day. It's the next day, and I'm back at this little city park. I'm using my small coil this time. Still no probe. And I just got a, this is a 40 signal, pretty solid 40 signal. And that is a nickel. And it looks shiny. Oh yeah. Awesome. It's a 19. If I can focus. It's a 1943. Okay, just got my second find. I've dug a couple wheat pennies, a couple memorials. That's about it. And I just popped a buffalo out. It was right here on this clump. I already looked at it. I can tell it's a buffalo. Let me see if I can give it a little spit rub here. Hold on. There's not much I can do with this thing. It's a buffalo, though. And I doubt I can get a date off of this. So, that's that. I'm not going to clean it up anymore. Alright, this was a really deep penny, real warbly penny signal. And it turned out to be this thingy. Like a bolt. It's like a bolt cat, but it's acorn shaped. That's kind of cool. Looks old. There you go. It's heavy too. Alright, I'm back at this little field today. It's the end of the day. Didn't have much time left. Anyway, I got my probe back today. Guy put a whole brand new probe with the wire on it. The invoice said my falsing was caused by a loose nut on this switch, which I didn't check, so I don't know. I didn't notice it was loose, but I didn't look at it either. But that's what the invoice said the falsing was, but he replaced the whole probe too. Who knows? Anyway, it's got my first good target here. Where'd it go? Here it is. Silver dime. This was really screaming. It was jumping in between a dime and quarter. Let's see, it looks like a 39. It's a D. Cool. It's the only good thing I found so far. I've been here about an hour. Found 75 cents. Three quarters. One penny. That's it.